The minister's remarks were in response to the Parliamentary Committee of Finance chaired by Amos Kankunda, the Rampara County MP, which expressed concern over the decision by the World Bank. Musasizi told the committee that government is ready to carry its cross since the anti-homosexuality law was supported by Ugandans.
I'd like to request that he reiterates this. He mentioned the fact that he's going to invite us to engage us to see how we revise even our budget. And it is important that it comes out clear and you know, even come up with supplementaries, adjustments of the budget, which might eventually even affect
financial management revolves. Some of us who are professionals in that area, we know how far we have worked with the evolutions in financial management for some years. And as a result, there is a need for us to keep interacting, exchanging ideas, providing information to the stakeholders. And because of this, we are proposing that we have an interaction with you outside this environment.
Musasizi told legislators to tighten their belts as Uganda faces the moment of truth, saying they have no option but to revise the budget to absorb the World Bank's potential impact. He hinted on the need to adjust several expenditures, including emoluments of public servants.
We took the decision and we are firm, but we knew, and the president told us, that we are going this route. Should it develop, should it bring consequences, then we should be able to bear.
Musasizi, however, didn't elaborate on what the revision of the 52.7 trillion shillings national budget will entail, saying this will be done in a week's time after Parliament returns from recess. Legislators have come out to advise government to cut its coat according to its cloth in order to endure the hard times ahead.
World Bank loans are usually low interest loans and payable on a longer term basis. So once they decide not to lend to us, it means some of our operations, especially development expenditure, will be affected.
So it will still give us room, because salary is about wellness, about welfare, about people's lives. We can look at, as I mentioned, on non-wage, and we can look at some development budget lines, which are not critical, might not be immediate, or we might delay some of those development budget lines.
When we're passing this law, we expected to see various sectors affected by funding from most of the foreign donors. So when you look at the external financing that we get and budget support we are getting, that is figures we are talking about close to 10 to 11 trillion shillings that is coming in from the external financiers, the IMF, the World Bank. So we expect all this money to reduce, and we expect to have a smaller resource envelope than we have right now.
However, some members of parliament believe World Bank's decision is a blessing in disguise, as it may see government rethink its priorities and minimize wasteful expenditure to stay afloat.
This World Bank thing, for once, is going to instill discipline in the way we manage our economy. It's going to be a very hard and rough road, but we needed this to go through, so that for once we live in reality.
President Museveni responded to the World Bank's action on his Twitter handle and denounced the World Bank's decision to suspend new funding in response to the homosexuality law. The president vowed to find alternative sources of credit. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.